this is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video, and another video inside of Stampy's lovely world. Good morning, William Beaver. Good morning. Are you ready for a good old-fashioned round of boat bowling? Hopefully you are, because that's what we're doing. But I'm not only going to be joined by William today, I am also going to be joined by Polly Reindeer and Fizzy Elephant as well. So yeah, we're going to have the first ever boat bowling tournament. If I'm going to be having a tournament, I want to be doing it with a full belly. So let me go and nom 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 nom. Have my breakfast. Barnaby, we can come and take you to the doghouse, and then we can teleport straight to the Funland so we can begin playing the game. So we've been building the game in the last couple episodes. As you haven't seen that, you can check them out to kind of see exactly what it is we're doing. I think it's going to be a fun game. And oh, where am I going? I keep forgetting where I'm adding people. Oh yeah, today I'm going to be adding Elliot. And the reason I'm adding Elliot is because he made a Stampy Cat out of these building blocks. And it's kind of crazy that he was able to make it look like me with kind of all of those weird shaped blocks. And he's even balanced two curved blocks to make my whiskers as well. And I thought that was really cool. So I wanted to say thank you very much, Elliot, and welcome to my love garden. Okay, Barnaby, let's go and get you to the doghouse. And Minecraft helpers, I hope you are ready. I hope you are prepared to start doing some boat bowling. I'm actually really looking forward to this game because we haven't had any games since the last episode. Like we all had a bit of a practice just like moving the boats around to get better. But yeah, just to kind of show to Polly exactly how it works and things, but we haven't had a game yet, so we're going to have our first really proper game with the rules finalized today. And let's have, I don't know who to choose, let's have Flippy, you can join us today. I'm afraid we can't choose Harriet. Harriet won't come all the way to the final. If she would come, I would invite her, but she won't. It looks like Fizzy's going to try and take Harriet to the game with us. If you can get her over to the game, Fizzy, then that's fine by me, but good luck trying to nudge her the entire way there. Right then, let's go down to the secret base, to the teleporter, which is luckily right next to where we're going to be playing the game. And I haven't changed anything since the last episode. We did a good job getting everything done. The only small thing I changed is I just added some more lights. I added some glowstone just to basically light up the area a little bit. And thank you, very considerate of you, Flippy, giving me a spare boater in case we need it, because we are gonna need a lot of boats today because they are gonna be going all over the place. So let's go and get Flippy into the teleporter, and I'll see you all when we arrive. Let's go and pull the lever and press the button, and right off we go to the Funland. Right then, here we are, safe and sound in the Funland. You can come with me, Flippy, and you can go and watch on the game. Sadly, like pretty much all of my mini games, no dogs allowed. Like, I would let the dogs play, but I don't know, sometimes they have a little bit of a trouble understanding the rules and end up just getting stuck in places and getting hurt. And oh, it looks like Fizzy's Mooshroom has finished its once-in-a-lifetime roller coaster ride. I think that's probably the world's dizziest Mooshroom right there. All right then, do you want to go, tell you what, we could try and put you on like the up here maybe? If I kind of run around up here, maybe Flippy will teleport behind me. I don't know. We'll let Flippy go where Flippy wants to go. I just don't want her to get in the way, but I wanted to have a nice view over the entire game as we go to play. So yeah, you can choose where we put Flippy, Fizzy. Right then, let's go and begin. So we're gonna do one against one, and then one against one, and then the winners play each other for the final. So shall we go first, Fizzy? Shall we have the first round? So the way we're gonna do this is we're gonna put down 10 lily pads each. Fizzy, don't forget the lily pads. We're gonna put down 10 lily pads each in the middle, and we're gonna say the first person to destroy 7 wins. No, 8. The first person to destroy 8 is going to win. And 8 might seem like a bit of a weird random number. The reason I'm doing 8 is because 5 seemed like too many. No, 5 seemed like not enough, but then 10 seemed like too many, because there is a chance you could get like 5 in like one go or something. So I think 8 is like a nice middle ground, I think. So first person to destroy 8 lily pads is the winner, but we're going to do 2 rounds. So we're going to take turns going first. So tell you what, Fizzy, I'll let you go first, and then I'll go first, second. So if you come out here now, Fizzy, go back through the tunnel. And so, yeah, if you haven't seen the last episode, the way this works is you launch a boat from these dispensers and kind of push them forward, and we just keep count of how many lily pads you break, and whoever is the first person to break 8, as I mentioned, will be the winner. So Fizzy's kind of having a bit of a look around and deciding which dispenser to start from, which is a very important part of the game as well. You want to get the perfect angle to break the lily pads, and it looks like he's made his decision. So you get to go first, Fizzy. So whenever you go, and oh, there are quite a few lined up there. And that was a good push. That's one. Oh no, it was all, it looked like a good push and then it just stopped. Okay, maybe that wasn't the best go, but that was 1 point for Fizzy. There's plenty of time for him to make a comeback. So where shall I go? Look, there's two right next to each other there. Look, I might be able to get that one and then them two. That might be a good first go for me. So let me kind of try and do that, and let's kind of give a bit of a punch. There we go. That's two. Can I get another one? That's three. Is that all? And look, it went all the way to the other side. That was a lot of power from my go there. So that's 3 points to me, and it's going to be Fizzy's turn to go next. So whenever you're ready, Fizzy, you can go and place down the boat. And yeah, go and have your next game. So he's put down the boat. Looks like he's going for a diagonal one here. No, he went for a punch. That was good. Oh no, it went straight between them. But that's one, two. Is he going to get that third one? Yes, three. That was an amazing go by Fizzy. That's 3 points to Fizzy. So he's now back in the lead with 4 points. That was pretty incredible, if I may say so myself. Right. I'm going to make a decision now for where I'm going to go next. Maybe like, maybe along this way. If I do this one, but kind of go slightly diagonal that way, there's quite a few I might be able to get there. So let's try and like run at this one a little bit diagonally like that. And oh no, that wasn't very good. Oh, where's the boat gone? Okay, the boat hasn't gone past the line, so I'm still okay, but I've kind of put it in a little bit of an awkward situation for myself here. Let's try and get a good push and try and punch it. There we go. I got one. Am I going to get another one? Two. Is there going to be a third one there? I don't think so. So that's 2 points for me. That could have been really good, but I didn't do very well. So kind of goes without saying. You're up now, Fizzy. So the score is currently 4-5. But of course, you know, Fizzy is kind of going first. So he kind of hasn't had his go yet. And oh, that was a high speed one. He got one, two, and then hit one of the other boats. Fizzy's doing very well now. So Fizzy now has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points. 6 points for Fizzy. Fizzy only needs one more in order to be able to beat me. So I need to get 2 lily pads now in order to be able to win. Otherwise, it looks like Fizzy is going to win. So let's get a good angle. Maybe like, all of the ones that were nicely lined up have gone, oh, maybe straight down, oh yeah, straight down that way. If I get a high speed one, I should be able to get them two, and then that will be me winning the round. So let's try and get a good charge. Oh no, I just sprinted over it. No, I don't want to do this. I want to get a good high speed go. There we go. And it's off. Oh no, but I didn't get them. Am I going to get any of them? Oh no, I went straight through everything. I just wanted to get them two. That was a really bad go by me. So Fizzy, you now need to destroy one lily pad in order to win the game, basically. And it looks like he's trying to do exactly what I tried to do. Can he do it better? And he has done it. Oh, he only got one though. So he was only just able to win. But a win is a win. So you have won round number one. So that doesn't mean that he's kind of won outright. It means that he's kind of won the one where he went first. We're going to have another game now where it's going to be me going first. And so if he wins that, then he has overall won. If I win, I guess we need to do kind of like some type of like a tiebreaker, I guess. I actually, I haven't really thought about exactly what we're going to do if it does come to a tie. So if it does come to that, maybe we can do like a go where we take turns trying to just break one lily pad, or maybe there's a lily pad in the middle and we both fire at the same time. That might be the fairest way to do it, maybe. So yeah, we'll work that out when it comes to it. So for now, we can go and just place down all of the lily pads again. Do you ever have one more lily pad on you? Do you have 11? Do you want to? Okay, so there should be There should be a lily pad. Oh, there we go. There's one left here. So let's just leave that one there. And let's spread out all of the other ones. I think the best way to do this is kind of just to do like a bunch of parkour. I kind of just like place them and jump between them. It makes it quite fun as well. Let's go and place one there. And there's quite a big gap over here as well. So let's go and place one down here. So I'm expected to win this round because I get to go first. Hopefully, unless I muck up big time like last time, hopefully I should be able to win. And allow us to go to the tiebreaker, whatever that's going to end up being. So, right, let's pick a good start here. I want to get rid of at least three, I think, for the first go, just seeing how many there are there. And I think maybe straight down this line here. Look, there's three in a row there. So if I do this one but go slightly to the right, that might be the way to do it. Let's kind of go like this. And then there we go. That's some good speed. One, two. Am I going to get a third one? Three. Am I going to get a fourth one? That's the big question. Four. This might be a record for one go. Am I going to get five? Oh, if that was a bit faster, I'd have got five. Oh, it's still going. It's still going. Go on. Make it to five. Please make it to five. Oh, look, there we go. Five. That was an unbelievable go. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points for me. And so, yeah, luckily we're not playing to five still, because otherwise I would have won on my first go. Right, Fizzy Elephant, it's your go next. So, yeah, it's going to be very difficult for Fizzy to win this round, but he did win the last round. And it is possible if I don't get my next one, he could still win. Let's see how many he can get. That's one. It looks like he's going to get at least one other one. Yeah, there we go. There's two. And then is he going to get a third one? It's once again going very, very close. I think he might about get it. Oh, look at it. Look how close it is. Is it going to get it? I don't think it's going to get it, though. It's just parked right next to it. You can see him there willing it on, trying to tempt it with cookies. But sadly, nope. It looks like it stopped moving. And then that was 2 points for Fizzy. So now I need to, so I got five, so I need to get two, don't I? I need to get two more lily pads in order to win. So is there a place with two lily pads close to together? I want to find ones quite close to the dispenser in case I muck it up. Oh, over there. There seems to be two here. Let me see. Does this line up to any of the dispensers nicely? If I do this one and aim slightly right, I might be able to get them two there. So that's what my strategy is going to be. Let's try and get a nice good nudge. Oh, come on. Let's make sure it goes fast. Let's give it a bit of a punch maybe. Oh, no. Go faster. There we go. Good speed. One. Am I going to be able to get another one? Oh, I might bounce the boat. There we go. There's two. So that's the win. Am I going to get any more? But nope. It looks like that was the end of that round. So there we go. We are now at a little bit of a tiebreaker, I guess, at this point. So let's go and get rid of all the boats and the lily pads. And I'm going to think about what I'm going to do. So I think maybe having one lily pad placed in the middle and whoever gets to destroy it first, maybe that would be a way to do it. And then we can just have everyone else kind of watching and judging to decide who the winner is. Who the winner is going to be. So let's kind of put maybe one lily pad right in the very middle, and then we can have either Polly or William being a judge to decide whose boat was the one that actually destroyed the lily pad. I think that's just about the fairest way we can do this. So let's put, there we go, one lily pad in the middle there. Let's go down to the underneath, and of course we can't take turns because otherwise someone else is going to have an advantage. So we'll just do it at the exact same time. Okay, that's what the plan's going to be. So it looks like Polly is there ready to watch. So Polly, you just need to point to whoever you think was the one who fired the boat that destroyed the lily pad. So let's go and get lined up here. I'm going to get my boat ready. I'm going to go 3, 2, 1, and then we can begin pushing the boat. This is actually really, really tense, because if I lose this, then I am out. Right then, so begin, Fizzy, in 3, 2, 1, and go. Right, I want to push this boat as fast as I can. This is all about speed. And then we'll go. I did it. Yes, I was able to destroy it. I have all, but I know I won. You don't need to point, Polly. That was very, very tense. Well played, though, Fizzy. Well played. You did amazing in that first round, and it came right down to the nails and the tiebreaker. So that was exciting. Right then, now it is going to be Polly going up against William Beaver. So Polly, do you want to come and grab these lily pads? There's one more in the middle to make your 10. Fizzy, if you go and pass all of yours to William, you guys can go and head to the middle, and we're going to do the same thing again. So they're going to have basically two games against each other. And then the winner out of them is going to play against me in the boat bowling grand final. So let's go and start filling up some of these dispensers while we wait. I'm kind of becoming a little bit overrun with boats at the moment. So let's go and try and fill some of these up just to empty my pockets a bit. And this is going to be very important for me because I'm going to have to see who I'm going to be playing against. And I can also kind of have a bit of time to see what their strategy is and, you know, make sure I can kind of play against it when I go up against them. When we had our little bit of our boat training earlier, Polly seemed to be really well. Polly kind of worked out a really good technique. She's the one who discovered that kind of punching the boat helps out. So yeah, we're going to have to see how well she's going to do in her first actual proper game. So right, that's kind of all of these dispensers nicely filled up. It looks like William's just placing the last of the lily pads down. So Polly, I guess you can have the first round. So as soon as William's poked down, feel free to press the button and begin the first game. And I'm going to be here watching and keeping count. The good thing is it's very easy to keep count just because you can see like all of the particles popping up. So you can very easily see how many lily pads are broken. And there we go. That was a good one. And that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, and then it just stopped. It went really fast, and then it just stopped. I thought that was going to even be more than 4, but that is a very good start for Polly, and you see how fast she made the boat go. She has a very good technique, so William is going to have to play very well to get a comeback in this round, but I'm sure he's going to try his best. So whenever you're ready, William, go and launch the boat and see if you can do better than 4. You can see he tried. You can see he tried to do the punching technique. It didn't go quite as fast, but that's still 2 taken out, possibly a further. No, no, it went straight between the other 2. That was quite unlucky there. But there we go. That was 2 down for William. It's going to be Polly's go again now. So whenever you're ready, Polly, go and launch the next boat. And oh, didn't go quite as fast that time, but that's still 2 broken. Now 3. Is there going to... Oh, 4 again. That means Polly has got 8 points in just 2 goes. That is unbelievable. Polly looks like she is the person to beat. But don't worry, William, because you get to go next. And you get to go first this time. So that should help him out a lot. So do you guys want to go into the middle and put down all of the lily pads again? And yeah, they can have the next round. So basically, if Polly wins this round, then that means she is going to be going up against me in the final. And then if William wins, we're going to go and have another tiebreaker situation. So it's going to be very difficult for Polly to win just because she's not going first. But then again, if she plays the way she did then and gets 8 points in 2 goes, then wow, she really did put on a show. She does seem to be the person to beat. And the Mooshroom's come to join us. The Mooshroom has decided to come and watch the game. It was like, what's all of this commotion going on inside of here? Let's go and see what's happening. It's Fizzy's friend, the Mooshroom. Right then, let's see how many lily pads are down. It looks like most of them are down already. There is some strategy to placing the lily pads down as well, because if you know you're going first, you can kind of put like a few closer to together in a row, knowing that you can, you know, you can kind of go after them. So there is a bit of thought that you can when to put down the lily pads. I think there's one kind of still in there like that. So what I'm going to do, I think that's not enough. I'm going to go and grab just one extra lily pad from here. I got some spare ones here in case we needed them. So let's just go and place down one more lily pad on the inside from here, just to make sure there are 20 inside of the game. So William, where is William? William, it's your turn to go first. So whenever you're ready, step up to whichever dispenser you want and launch your first boat. And good luck. To be honest, I'm not envying you right now, having to go up against Polly, but I'm going to have to do it soon. And careful, William nearly broke his own boat then. That would have been a very bad start. But that was 1, 2. Is it going to get any more? It looks like it's pretty much come to a halt now. It's very close to another one. Didn't quite make it, but there we go. That is 2 points for William. A pretty average score. You know, that's kind of, you know, you want to get at least 2, I would say, on the first round. So Polly's going to have her work cut out of her in order to win just because she's going second. But she had an amazing round last time. Let's see if she can do the same thing here. You can see her really thinking hard to choose where to go. And oh, there is a quite nice row of them there. So if she gets a good, fast, accurate shot here, she might be able to kind of do a repeat of the last round. And oh no! She broke the boat! She destroyed her own boat! Oh dear, that's not looking good for Polly. William, it's your turn next. You can see that in her attempt to get a lot of speed, she actually punched it too much and ended up destroying her own boat. So sadly, no lily pads for Polly. So it's your turn now, William. It looks like he's going to go and use Polly's strategy and kind of launch the boat from the exact same place. Not a huge amount of speed. Oh, we try to get a bit of an extra push. It's going in the right direction, but very, very slowly. He's going to be lucky to get even one lily pad here. It looks like it might not make it. Oh, it's very close. He might be able to get one. Oh, look at it. Look how close it's getting. And it has stopped. Oh no, it's still going. Nope, it stopped. It stopped. Sorry, William. It wasn't quite strong enough. It looks like the pressure is getting to both William and Polly at the moment. They're both struggling to get any. So this is your chance to redeem yourself now, Polly. Are you going to be able to make up for the next round? I know for sure she's not going to punch it as much as she did last round. That's for sure. But there we go. That was some pretty decent speed. That was one lily pad broken. Is she going to get any more? It went right between them. Look at that. It went right between them. Ooh, if she knocks another boat and that hits a lily pad, that still does count. But that was only one broken for Polly. I know she's going to be pretty disappointed with that score. But this is going to be a close game, actually. All right, William, do you want to go and launch the next boat? Let's see if you're going to be able to do any better this round. That's okay speed. There have been some pretty slow ones overall so far. That was another lily pad broken, though, but it doesn't look like it's going to get any more. But he still has a good lead at Polly at the moment anyway, so that's an extra point for William. So it's 3-1 at the moment. It's still anyone's game, to be honest, especially if Polly has some rounds like she did in the last time. It looks like anyone could win at the moment, so... whenever you're ready, Polly, pick which dispenser you want to launch your boat from, and good luck. Ooh, there's a lot very close here together. If she gets good enough speed and doesn't break her boat, it looks like she's guaranteed to get at least two, possibly even more with this go. It's kind of a bit harder to launch from the corner, and whoa, like a rocket. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's coming back as well. The boat's coming back. Is it going to get any more? 5? Any more? Is it going to get the last one? If it breaks that one, she's won. 6! Polly has won. She got 6 lily pads in one go. You, Polly, have definitely made up for the last few rounds. 6 lily pads in one go. That was an unbelievable shot. Well done, Polly. Sorry, William Beaver, it was so close, but sadly it just wasn't to be. Right then, time for the final, Polly. Let's go and head to the middle. William Beaver, do you want to kind of help maybe clean up some of the boats just to get the game ready? And yeah, we need to do the same thing again. Place down 10 lily pads each. And then, yeah, first to get 8 is going to be, the winner. So who's going to go first? You can go first if you want, Polly. You can go and launch the boat first, and I'll go second. I'll be a gentleman and let Polly go first. But first, let's go and gather up all of these lily pads, and then once I've got 10, I can go and start placing them all down. So there we go. That's I've got 11, so there's an extra one there in case you need it, Polly. I think we might have one extra at the moment. And to be honest, if there's 21, it doesn't really matter too much. So I guess I really want to kind of spread these out quite a lot, especially as Polly's going first, because I've seen what she can do when they're grouped together, and I don't want her to do that against me. I'm pretty nervous about this, because Polly, if she has a round like she did, you know, that final go or the first round against William, things don't look very good for me. But that's all of my lily pads done, so let's go down here. Polly, you can go, as I said, you can go first. So as soon as you're ready, go and pick which dispenser you want to fire it from. And good luck, I guess. Good luck. Let's see how well this is going to go. And oh, there's a few boats still left. So before you go, Polly, let's just go and destroy these, because otherwise these might end up kind of getting in the way or kind of getting bounced. So let's just go and destroy all of these. Right then, Polly. So yeah, pick where you want to fire from, and we can go and begin the final round. I just saw Fizzy just jumping around on the Mushroom Mountain over there, just with her new friends. And oh, she's launching from a corner. It is more difficult, but she has had a good success from this in the past. You can see the way she's kind of lining it up perfectly. And oh, she didn't get as much speed as she would have liked, but that was still pretty good. That's 1, 2. It looks like she might be able to get at least one more, maybe all 3. Is she going to be able to get a fourth one, though? That's the big question. She might, actually. She might be able to get a fourth one. Nope, it looks like it has stopped there. So that's 4 points for Polly. A very good score for the first go. So I'm kind of tempted to launch my boat into her boat, and then that way I might be able to get more. No one's really tried that as a strategy. Much under, whoa! Another one just went, Polly. You got another one. That's five. Five on her first go. Right. I need to do something amazing if I'm going to have any chances. So, right. I'm just going to launch my boat straight into hers and hope they bounce around and I get lots, because I think that's my only chance of winning. Because if she's going to get five in one go, what else can I do? So that's one. Am I going to get any more? Two. I think I might get three from that one there. Then that might be it. That strategy worked actually pretty well. So that's a 3 points for me. So it's 3-5. So that means if Polly can get rid of two lily pads on this go, then she would have won this round. And then she only needs to win one more go to be the overall champion. It looks like there's a few lined up quite nicely there. That's going to be one. And oh, it stopped. It just stopped. She only needed to get one more, but it just stopped right before it. Okay, I'm still in with a chance here, actually. So I need to get four in order to win. So it's a tall order, but not impossible. Right, let's go for my knocking the boats together strategy again, because that worked quite well. Let's launch this one towards that boat there and see how well that works, because I need to get so many destroyed. I'm going to go and try and go slightly diagonal that way as well. So this is very doable. I've got four before, so I might be able to do it again. And oh no, that won't do. I got two. Am I going to be able to get another one? There's still a chance here if Polly has a bad go for me to win. I'd have liked to have at least got three though, but it looks like I am not getting any more. So that brings my score now to five. So we both have five, but of course Polly gets Polly's got six, sorry. So Polly only needs one lily pad in order to win. So she basically just needs to not make a mistake, and she's been able to win this round. So I think she's going to be very careful not to break this boat. Look how confident she is. Just a small tap and she smashes it straight in. Well played, Polly. Well played. So she hasn't won yet, but if she wins the next round against me, then she is the champion. All right then, let's go and head straight back into the middle and go and begin the next round. I'm not gonna lie, this is really, really tense right now. This is genuinely making me very nervous. Like, I want to win. Of course I want to win. I always play my mini games to win. You know, that's how it's good fun. Like, I don't care if I lose, but you know, you might as well play to try and win. And Polly has just been playing so unbelievable. I think the chances of me winning are pretty slim, but you know what? I am going to go and give it my very best shot. So let's just go and break away some of these boats and gather up the lily pads. So there we go. These are my 10 lily pads. And I get to go first. So I kind of want to group some to together a little bit here, just so I kind of have a better chance on my first go. So I've got 11 here. There's a spare one in case you need it, Polly. No worries if you don't. So let's kind of like try and group a few kind of closer together. Like, I'm not just going to put them all in a line, because that probably wouldn't be very fair, but I want to have like a few kind of in the same kind of area, just to give me a fighting chance to be able to win this round. And let's just go and spread them over. Like, I don't want them too close together, because if I miss, which could very well happen, then Polly's just going to be able to get them all after me. So let's just go and spread some around here. Here's my final one I can place down there. And yeah, let's go and begin what could possibly be the final round. So just to remind you, if I win, we go to another decider. If Polly wins, she is straight up the champion. So I kind of lined up a few a little bit like across the middle. So I think I'm going to launch this one straight down the middle. And if I get enough speed, I might be able to get quite a few here. So let's go for a bit of a run-up. Let's kind of get it to the edge first. And can I get some speed? Oh, that was some good speed. One, two, three, four. Is there going to be a fifth? I think the lily pads kind of break its speed a little bit. But that was four. Okay, that was a worthy start by me. You know, there's been better starts from Polly, but four for the first go is certainly not bad. I mean, if I get three now, then I'll be able to win this round. But of course, we have all seen what Polly can do, and we've learned to expect the unexpected from her. So you can see her mind working as she kind of looks over the area, working at all of the different angles and the trajectories to kind of work out the best one to fire from. It looks like she's made her decision. She might be actually trying to bang it into my boat, maybe, or maybe just going straight down that way. Let's go and find out and let's see what she does. Oh, look how fast she makes it go by just tapping it. That's very impressive. That's two broken. It looks like it might be a third one about to get broken. Yep, that is three broken. And seeing as she didn't get to go first, that's very good for her to only be one behind me. So I need to get three in this round in order to kind of win outright. So I think I might play it safe. I think if I just go and break them two and possibly get another one behind me, that might be a good way to do it. So let's just try and get those two safely and then not worry about trying to get three this round. I just want to play it safe here just to make sure I don't end up getting none. So let's just try and get them two. There we go. Those them two. Can I possibly get a third one? There we go. That's three. That's three, which means I have won this round. That was, I must say so, even though I said it, I did it myself, that was a nice shot by me, which means we are going for another tiebreaker. Oh, this is going to be so unbelievably tense. To be honest, I don't fancy my chances, but I'm going to give it my best shot. So while you're in the middle there, Polly, do you want to break all of the lily pads and then place one roundabout in the middle? Of course, you can't place it exactly in the middle because there's the ladder there and you won't be able to get out. But if you place one roundabout in the middle, and William Beaver, do you want to be the judge? Okay, you need to watch very carefully and see whose boat is the one that breaks the lily pad, and then just point to whoever is the winner after that. So this is rather tense, to be honest. We're going to do the same thing we did last time, and I'm going to do a countdown, and then once I get to zero, we're just going to both fire the boats at the same time, and whoever does it first wins. So I think I'm going to go down from this side here, because it's kind of lined up quite nicely. Polly is there directly opposite me, so let me go and launch my boat from here, and we can fire it, Polly, in 3, 2, 1, and go, 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 go. Well, let's try and get as much speed as we can. Oh, go faster, faster, and Polly has one. Is anyone surprised? Did anyone not expect Polly to win? She has proved that she is by far the boat bowling champion. Congratulations, Polly! That game was so much fun. I really enjoyed it. I think I might work out a new way to do the sudden deaths possibly, but I think the way it worked then was pretty fine to be honest anyway, and that was a very enjoyable tournament. So that is boat bowling. Feel free to build the game yourself if you want to. The good thing about it is there's absolutely zero redstone, so I think it's going to be very popular. Anyway, that is the end of this episode here. Thank you so much to Polly, William, and Fizzy for joining in with all of the fun. Of course, thank you to all of you for watching the video as well, and we will see you all later. Bye!